What's up, guys? I just wanted to jump on YouTube here and share a few quick words about an awesome Airbnb I'm staying at. I'm down here in Alabama shooting a wedding video for BCS Blacksmith, as you guys would know him here on YouTube if you follow that channel. And all the hotels in the area had like bad reviews, and so I hopped on Airbnb, found this super great place called Cap's Caboose, where I happen to be right now, and I just wanted to share some thoughts about it. This place is by far like the coolest Airbnb I've ever seen. It's a real 1940s caboose that's been completely remodeled into a rustic looking tiny house. Now, I'm a young guy, I'm only 21, and as you know by this YouTube channel, I'm a techie. I make tech videos, love tech. So rustic isn't always my vibe, and I was a little skeptical when I was looking at the Airbnb listing for this place, but I literally just got here after the wedding rehearsal, after flying in, traveling today, and this place is cool. As a techie, I think this rustic place is cool. So I wanted to share some thoughts about it. Super cool vibe, nice and warm and cozy in here. It's a little dim. That'd be my only thing. Not super great for filming videos, but most people staying here probably aren't gonna be videographers who are trying to film videos at night. Just to go over some of the amenities for this place, free Wi-Fi speeds, they're not great, so don't plan on doing any heavy duty anything with it, but gets you connected, allows you to get some phone calls over Wi-Fi calling, as you would refer to that as. If you don't have phone service, definitely works good for that. It's enough to get you by for sure. It does have a full bathroom, full shower, which I mean, the shower head, considering like this is a pretty small caboose, is like pretty high. Like, I'm a 6'5 guy, and it definitely tall enough for me to get by with. Super cool sink in the bathroom as well. I love that. The super host, she is rated as a super host on Airbnb, which I think is well deserved. Like their shampoo, soap, everything. So if you're like me and you forgot to pack those things, they're here and ready to go. There's like dishes in the cupboards if you needed to do some stuff like that. Got, you know, full toaster oven, one burner electric stove, so you could do some cooking things. Definitely decent sized fridge, you know, kitchen cupboard space, Keurig coffee maker with provided Keurig K-Cup pods, so you know, you can get some morning coffee going. There is a remote in here providing access to the thermostat on the heaters. I know that's something a lot of Airbnb hosts like lock down on. They won't let you adjust your own heat. This place does, that's super nice. It's set to 65 though, which for what the weather is here in Alabama, like, feels perfect. I'm not gonna mess with that at all. Super great there. It's got a full queen size bed here in the main bedroom, and then the couch out there folds down into a twin bed, so you definitely, you know, if you needed to, you could cram up to four people in here if you're all buddies or, you know, small family, something like that. Definitely doable. Got a nice dining room table that you know, you could eat at, you know, do a little bit of work at if you needed to, or as mentioned earlier, you know, the bed's a solid office space if you're a young guy or a person like me. I mean, I'm super impressed with the amenities of this place. It's got a TV in that main living room area. It's got a smaller TV up in the bedroom, kind of right above me out of the camera angle here. Also got a fan in here if you like to have a fan on. I know I've never been a fanboy, as I refer to people like that as, but if you're one of the people that needs to sleep with a fan or something on, you're set, you're covered, you're good to go there. So really solid place. Keypad lock, you get to let yourself in. Super convenient. The hostess, for me, she just changed the code to the last four digits of my phone number. I assume she does that for everyone, but it makes it really nice and easy for when you check in. You can check in whenever it's convenient for you, because you punch in that code, you're here, you're good to go. And this place is so cool. I know I said this was gonna be a quick few words, but I just have a lot of really good things to say about this place. Once again, can't recommend it enough. Definitely check out the link in the description. Again, totally not sponsored. I'm just excited about how cool this place is. And I'm not gonna have time to visit it because I'm here like strictly business, but it's also pretty nearby, within 30 minutes of what looks like a really cool state park. So that is definitely a plus as well. Definitely, if any of you happen to be in Lineville, Alabama, And technically this is in Ashland, I believe. But I just wanted to leave this place a video review and throw it out there on the internet because I'm impressed by this rustic caboose tiny house. Looks super cool. I'm super excited to spend tonight and tomorrow night here. And yeah, I really wasn't planning on making this video at all, but I'm just beyond impressed by how cool this rustic caboose place is.